This is a Much Music special presentation.
And now, our feature presentation.
How are we doing? Anytime? In three? We on?
How you doing? My name's Bill. Of course, this is Paul, Gene, Ace, and Peter. I'm talking about KISS. You're watching Much Rocks Detroit Rock City.
KISS is in the film. The plot revolves around KISS, but can it be described as a KISS film?
I don't really think so. It does the film an injustice, and it kind of misleads people to call it a KISS film. It's really a film about KISS fans. KISS fans on this very comedic and almost disastrous journey to come to a KISS show during the 70s, trying to get to the hallowed Cobo Hall, you know, to see KISS on tour, and Eddie Furlong is in it, and a lot of great, you know, young actors, and it's a very funny film. It's much closer to Porky's or Fast Times at Ridgemont High than it is to Gone with the Wind.
Hours from now, we're actually gonna be seeing KISS, baby!
Don't you know what KISS stands for? Knights in Satan's Service!
We just watched Jam's mom torch our KISS tickets!
Nobody's missing that concert tomorrow night.
Hey, you little twerps. Give me your KISS tickets or I'll pop your faces in.
KISS sucks!
Peter, I'm losing you. There you are. 3, 2, 1.
Now, you are no strangers to film, because we can talk about KISS Meets the Phantom back in the 70s, even right up until this season's Millennium.
A lot of home movies.
I'm sure there are.
Actually, we shot Millennium in D.C.
Why is doing a film like this such a logical extension of the world of KISS?
Well, because we break rules, you know, and the idea really with KISS is that we won't be confined by the limitations that other bands have to live by. Mostly, they have to live by them because they don't have anything to offer outside of a very small sphere of music. So for a band like us, the idea of doing a film, especially Detroit Rock City, which is kind of like four young people's odyssey on the way to meeting the Wizard of Oz, in this case it's KISS, is very much like the story of KISS, who were four young people who went through all kinds of obstacles to attain what they wanted. We lived out our dream, and it's really the story of four people doing the same. It's kind of like a cross between Fast Times at Ridgemont High and the Wizard of Oz, as opposed to a Hard Day's Night.
What a great parallel.
I like that parallel.
I get it. Homer and KISS.
Yeah.
Makes sense to me.
Action! Keep throwing punches!
The story is set in 1978, and it's about four fanatical KISS fans who are desperate to sneak into a sold-out KISS show. They had tickets. One of them has a very strict mom. The mom destroyed the tickets, and now they're on a quest. We've got to get in somehow. And of course, everything goes wrong along the way, as is the case with any good film that has conflict and obstacles for our characters, whom we root for, to overcome.
And the editing will reflect a Sergei Eisenstein kind of...
Very much so, yes. We're going to have Gene Simmons rolling down the stairs, much like the baby carriage.
And it's a quest. It's a rite of passage film. It's the ultimate rite of passage film. And I can't tell you much more. You have to see the ending of the film to see. But I can tell you the finale will be an incredible concert put on by Kiss, performing Detroit Rock City.
It comes on strong. Tell me what I got to do. I got to get up. Everybody's gonna move their feet. Get down. Everybody's gonna leave their seat. You gotta lose your mind in Detroit Rock City. Get up. Everybody's gonna move their feet. Get down. Everybody's gonna leave their seat. That is late. I just can't wait.
Why is film and Kiss go so well hand in hand?
Kiss is like a brand name kind of thing, so, and it's very, it's not just a musical band. It's like, you know, it's a lot like WWF, so it's a lot of, you know, it's a lot of pyro, it's a lot of fun, it's a lot of, you know, kookiness, and you can't get too kooky for us. So it's, you know, that kind of goes hand in hand with film, because a lot of people want to say, well, I'm an artist, and I write about music, and then I can't be an actor, and Kiss acts their whole life, you know, so this is perfect for it.
Detroit Rock City, brought to you by Detroit Rock City, now playing in theaters everywhere.
It's unanimous. Detroit Rock City rocks.
Hands down, best movie of the summer.
I'm definitely going to see it again. I thought it was great. It was really funny. Absolutely hilarious.
It just rocks in so many different levels.
I lived that whole era. It was amazing.
Those jeans are so tight. I can see your pee.
This movie is so good.
It's the best movie I've seen all summer.
Detroit Rock City rocks.
Detroit Rock City, now rocking in theaters everywhere.
It's a great movie. Go see it.
Visit the site with
C-Camera.
C-Camera!
The film wasn't written for you. You were brought on after you approved of what you saw in terms of the script.
Actually, the history of it was that we were developing a motion picture of the highest level, I might add, at the same time that this was being developed as a TV movie of the week. And when the motion picture part of it took too long, we decided to kick up the TV version into a feature film, and it was actually beefed up, and so here we are today, Detroit Rock City. Actually, the cool thing about Detroit Rock City is that it's being done from director to art director to the movie studio by Kiss fans. This is really a Kiss film about the fans, made by the fans who became the power elite.
Are we reloading?
Yes.
Keep punching and keep punching. Just because it's going to be so slow that any lack in more punching is going to seem like forever.
Yeah. I can't see anybody telling Kiss what to do.
Ready?
And you being a director would have to be in that position.
I kick their ass. I don't let them get away with anything. I'm not intimidated. I tell them, I'm the director, you're the actors, and do what I say. And they promptly escort me from the building.
I was gonna say, okay.
No, they're great guys. And I've been a huge Kiss fan all my life. And the idea of actually getting to direct Kiss, tell them what to do, is unbelievable.
I'm thinking you have to walk away from the headspace where you are a fan. You're on a working level. You're on a working relationship level with them. Is that difficult?
It was at the beginning, because I grew up being a huge fan of Kiss. So trying to get yourself into the mindset that we are contemporaries, we are collaborating on this film together, and my opinions are as valid as theirs in reference to the Kiss movie is a weird headspace to get into. But once you get that all behind you and you realize, all right, we have a movie to make, it just becomes second nature.
Right, well, you'll just fake it for all these, and then we'll do a separate piece of just that. But you'll fake it, and so you'll blow it, and then, you know, throw the thing back down.
The neat thing about the movie is everybody involved in making this movie is a Kiss fan. So the fun thing about this movie is that it's about the fans, for the fans, by the fans. And that's what makes it so much fun.
Barry's one of the producers here on the set of Detroit Rock City. Barry, do you want to come here for a second? Before we do the interview, you're a big guy here on the set. You're the producer. Can you fire people? I just want to see you fire someone. Anybody, just fire someone.
Jimmy, you're gone. You're history.
What do you mean, man?
I don't give a shit. You're history.
Relationship with Kiss, it goes back years and years ago.
It goes back to 1976 when I first did a photo session with them in early 76, and I guess they liked what I did. We did the famous 1776 poster. Relationship with the guys, and it's come full circle to 1998, and I'm producing my first film with Kiss.
Now, in the interim, have you kept up a relationship with the boys?
Oh, yeah. I mean, we talk to each other all the time. I mean, we live near each other. I see them all the time. I see Gene. I see Paul.
Barry Levine has been Paul's lover for about 25 years. But I mean that. I mean that in the nicest way.
That's
nice. Coming from somebody with breasts.
And he. But when Gene says we've all beefed up, it's serious.
What the hell is that growing out of the side of your?
Don't be jealous now. You can have fun too.
But they do hug each other when they see each other, and that's because they've been good friends for years.
Barry's cool. Barry's been with us a long time. Barry took some of the best pictures ever really taken of Kiss. That's true.
They've been trying to get a film off the ground for the past 10 years. But the kind of film that they wanted to get off the ground basically was more of a sci-fi action adventure film. So this was the least of their concepts. And I found this script a couple of years ago, about 2.5 years ago. I sent the script to Gene. Gene read it, loved it. After they had to wait until their tour was finished. When the tour was finished, we sat down and we worked on the script, did a few rewrites, and finally came up with what New Line perceives as Detroit Rock City.
Punch! Keep throwing punches! Stay together!
Well, see, we're trying to do this fight scene. I fell and came under my knee pad, and the gravel attacked me.
There was skin hanging off.
Yeah, there was skin hanging off, man. It's pretty bad. But they treat me like I'm a baby or something. Come on, I'm an actor. I'm not a pro football player.
Don't worry about it. They're at my house. They're perfectly safe. You can go there right after school and pick them up.
Dude, hours from now, we're actually going to be seeing Kiss.
All right, man. We'll just double time it to your house, man. We'll grab the tickets, then we'll head to the train station for the 345 to destroy it.
From my elbow.
Let's sell it, guys.
You know, you play a Kiss fan.
I play
in
one of the
real
Kiss
life, are you?
Fanics. In real life, one of my favorite movie soundtracks is Dazed and Confused. So they have a Kiss song. They have a little tribute to Kiss in the movie. I don't know if you've ever seen it. And, you know, that's like my first introduction to, you know, rock and roll all night. But personally, I've never been to a Kiss concert, so I haven't really experienced it firsthand, you know, and I think a lot of people change when they finally go to a concert. From what I've heard, you know, I met a lot of fans coming on set, and it's pretty, you know, there's a lot of Kiss fans. And we had like 500 people come for free, you know?
Yeah.
So I guess people are really excited, you know, like Kiss is back and, you know, they're going on their world tour. Now they're going to have a movie to go see, you know?
Am I going across his face and I need to go more?
Not quite enough. Yeah, really.
Okay, all right.
Let's fill your mouth with blood, too, so that when you do that, it's just, then just spit it.
Oh, my God.
Oh, man, that's what I'm saying.
That's not stage blood. That's real blood. We insist on total accuracy here Detroit Rock City.
Can you explain who your character is and what the scene was happening tonight?
Well, I play Hawk, and I'm kind of, I don't know, kind of the guy who thinks and tries to get everything done, tries to get us to the concert, so I mean, sort of the leader, I don't know. And right now, what's going on is we're basically beating the crap out of each other, because, you know, we've lost our tickets, we want to get in, there's only a few minutes before the concert, and we decide that we're just gonna kick each other's asses and get to the concert that way and say we got mugged.
Now, in the film, did it work? Did you actually get in because of the fight?
You'll have to go see the movie now, won't you?
That moment.
No, in real life, you like Kiss?
I mean, I do. I like Kiss. I like what they stand for. I wouldn't say that I was like always the biggest avid Kiss fan, you know. I kind of like, you know, like Led Zeppelin and all of that. I love that era, but
you know full well though the impact that they had.
Oh yeah. Yeah. I mean, they look like rock and roll.
Are you a fan?
I am now, you know. I mean, I always knew who they were, and I always like enjoyed listening to their music, but I haven't really listened to it until I got this job. And now I have like 6 CDs, and like, you know, I listen to it every day.
Do you look at them as co-workers, as actors in a film that you're working on, or do you look at them
yet.
As Kiss?
Oh yeah, they're Kiss. Are you kidding me? It's like a force of nature. You can't screw with Kiss. It's Kiss.
Night is young, filled with possibilities.
Beth? Yes?
It's a girl walking along the side of the highway. We should pull over and help her out. I mean, they make scary movies that start out like that.
Hey, but they make porno movies that start out like that too, man.
You're the coolest.
Can you say what the relationship is with you
Absolutely.
And Jean?
Absolutely. Okay. But just don't call me a wife, because Jean will have a hissy fit.
Jean and Shannon are partners.
and Shannon. Yes, we've been living in sin for 15 years. We have 2 sinful children, Nicholas and Sophie. And I'm up here to support him on his film. And as a matter of fact, I have a part in the film.
Do you like the idea of it being a kind of a period piece?
You know, when you say 15, that, 20... all of a sudden I want to... I feel old. But you know what? I wasn't listening to Kiss in the 70s. I was into Motown. They were like the Antichrist to me, Kiss. That was scary stuff. I didn't want to have anything to do with those people.
Can you see the beauty in it looking back now?
I know. They don't sing about drugs or anything like that. They always sing about sex. I just couldn't understand what they were saying.
can you see the beauty in it now, though?
I can see. I get it now.
Okay.
I mean, I get it. I'm too old to love it, but I get it.
Much Rocks, Detroit Rock City, brought to you by Detroit Rock City, now playing in theaters everywhere. In 1978, when disco was on top,
I'm making it.
These guys partied to a different beat. Now, on one wild trip,
we are going to that concert.
They'll go all the way. And kiss the rules goodbye.
It's a girl walking along the side of the highway. They make scary movies that start out like that.
But they make porno movies that start out like that, too.
Detroit Rock City.
Now playing at theaters everywhere.
Saturday.
You gotta lose your mind in Detroit Rock City. Get up, everybody's gonna move their feet. Get down. I just can't wait. 10 o'clock, you know I gotta hit the road.
You know, it never seems to amaze you how loyal the Kiss Army is. Like, look at these people.
No,
a lot of people
amazing.
Have come in from, like, all over North America just to see Kiss perform one song.
You know what else is amazing now is I'm seeing a lot of 3-generation seating groups. I see you'll see a man who's probably the grandfather of the little kid sitting on the head of the 25 or 30-year-old man, you know? So it's like 3 generations watching the show, and it's a lot of fun to see that.
You have people flying in from Dallas to be here just to be part of this film from all over North America. So is this almost a nod to them as well?
Well, you know, our victories are always victories of our fans. You know, when we win, the fans win. If we celebrate 25 years of doing what we want and selling 70 million albums, it's really a victory of the people who made it possible. We couldn't have done it without them. So this film is really a vindication for them as well. I mean,
We are like a virus that just keeps coming back and permeating things. All of a sudden, the heads of record studios and film studios are Kiss fans, and we're taking over big time. We will not go away.
I feel uptight on Saturday night. 9 o'clock, the radio's the only light. I hear my song and it pulls me through.
Pansies from a fan, she just took them off.
There was a, you can see love on stage happening, so to speak. But there's also, no, there is like a lot of high fives, a lot of looks back and forth amongst the members.
That stuff you can't hide. You can tell when people want to be on stage with each other. And we're having the time of our lives.
Or be in bed with each other, for that matter.
Yeah, see the way we shake our heads like that?
The truth is, you know, a Kiss concert is something very unique, and what we have with our fans is something unique. When you come to a Kiss show like you did last night, there are no fans like ours. Other bands can talk about their fans. They can talk the talk, but we get to walk the walk. We do have the ultimate fans. They're tattooed for life. You know, they're the ultimate. And we can only do everything in our power to make sure we don't let them down.
You are fans, and you will be on the same screen as your heroes forever,
right?
Represented in film. Now, how does that make you feel?
Oh, it's great. I mean, I started playing because of the band, so just to help them out and be involved in this is a great thing.
It's just, you know, it's a really cool experience. It's something I'll be able to tell my grandkids about.
See myself in a Kiss film.
Now, why is that important to you, though?
It's just, you know,
part of history.
Yeah, exactly. Part of history, that's right. History. That's
it's
right.
A beautiful time to be a Kiss fan nowadays. Yeah. With everything that's going on with their popularity and the reunion to see Ace back in the band, it's fantastic.
We're here just for the fun. That's why we originally came down here. We just basically walked on set and we're here to have fun and we're doing it.
Beatles fans didn't get to do this. Elvis fans didn't get to do this. We do.
It's almost like payback for Kiss to put us in something like their movie, you know?
A lot of people want to know when they can see it in theaters.
It's going to be out in theaters sometime in 1999. I can't tell you specifically, but when it comes, you'll know, because Kiss does everything big.
Perfect. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
You know, I got to tell you, I'm a huge Kiss fan. I didn't want to say that earlier. I don't want to gaga or anything,
sure.
But I would love to be in a Kiss movie, to share screen time with Kiss.
You be in the Kiss
what
movie?
What a dream come true. Can you work that, do you figure?
Well, all the parts are pretty much cast, but I could maybe find something for you.
There's
a small little part.
Anything.
Okay, I'll find a small little part for you. Okay, we'll find
something. Great, thank you. Thanks, my friend.
No problem. Right. Okay.
Got to do the shot now up there. Big production meeting. We're going to barge right in here. Adam, can I ask you?
Talking about
Well, I'm part of the shot, if you don't mind.
Extras holding is over there. You can...
I'm an extra. I'm an actor. I have to know my motivation. Where I'm going with the scene.
Motivation.
What I'm thinking.
Motivation is
just
to get out of the way.
Yeah. Let me put it this way. Your motivation is to not mess up the f***ing shot, okay? Otherwise, you're out of here.
Oh, that's my motivation.
Yeah.
Stand by. Quiet. B-Mark. Speed.
Do I get an Oscar for that performance, do you think?
You get an Oscar Mayer wiener. That's what you get.
The backstage stuff. Was it, or even is it, as decadent as it was portrayed in the movie?
Rock and roll backstage is everything anybody can imagine and then some. It's no coincidence that politicians, actors, everybody wants to be a rock star. We have a president in the U.S. who wants to be a rock star. He's tried the lifestyle too. We get paid for it. He gets in trouble.
There was a lot of partying, but I think it's important for people to realize that with Kiss,
for the most part,
no booze, no drugs, but there is a lot of the other stuff going on.
Well, the other stuff means girls. The other stuff means girls. The booze and the drugs is always a stupid man's game, okay? The other stuff is smart. The other stuff is about enjoying yourself and not numbing yourself. We've got 5 senses that I know of, and going through life with your hands over your eyes doesn't fly. Going through, you know what I mean? So you've got to experience it all, and girls help us do that.
Was there a hot tub on the Love Gun tour backstage?
Was there a hot tub?
Yeah.
Yeah, actually,
there were several.
Some of the shows, we had a hot tub. And
we
were always looking for someplace hot and wet to jump in.
First album with the original lineup in almost 20 years. People talk about a band's chemistry or the magic. Is that something that's always there, or is that something you have to work at?
We have magic. We've always had magic.
There's a chemistry between the four of us then. I can't explain because we're all from such diverse backgrounds.
Asian criminal.
Yeah, I'm a criminal and a drug addict, or used to be, and a drunk. But, you know, all those things behind me, and you know, you hopefully you learn by your mistakes. But in any event, for some reason, when the four of us get together, there's a chemistry that happens that I can't explain. Opposites attract. I don't know. All I know is when the four of us get together on stage, it's magic.
Look at it this way, everybody needs a hero, and if you had a choice between somebody who dribbles a ball and throws it through a hoop, or this, which would you pick?
I'd pick the hoop, I think.
Yeah.
Michael Jordan.
I'd pick me. Like I'm a big fan.
Get up, everybody!